Adventures!
Hello, interwebs, and welcome back to Let's Play Phoenix Wright Trials and Tribulations. My name is SkiniMini.
And I'm Pharaoh.
What's so funny?
I don't know. There's something up that intro. It's like, it was more... Man, I don't want to say the word, but seductive?
What?
I don't know. It came off more soft-hearted. Welcome! Can you?
Alright, well, what a way to start the episode.
Hey!
We need to go see Pearl and break her Cyclox, so let's go!
Okay.
I'm already here.
Oh, I am not at all. I'm too busy. My brain left the train station. I don't even know what I'm saying anymore. Am I high?
I don't know. I should be asking that question.
I don't do any of that stuff. Oh my god. I'm here. Oh, look at that. They really did make a fire right in front of the shack.
Oh, Mr. Nick.
You're too late, Nick. If you came here for one of our potatoes, we've already polished them all off. I think I've pretty much got all the evidence I need.
Hey, can you turn down your gain real quick?
Yes, I can do that. Bleh. How's that?
Yell for me?
Ah!
Okay, that's good.
Okay. Now I just need to find out what Pearls is hiding.
Alright. Let's present the Megamatama.
Okay.
Pearlsy, you can't lie to us, remember. You're not good at it.
She's a very terrible liar.
Alright, the night of the crime.
Well, after dinner on the night of the murder, you were supposed to... Why does it keep making me laugh? She's not happy again.
She's like,
You were supposed to be in Elise Donim's room, reading a book together, correct?
Yes! I was so happy when she invited me, but I didn't go in the end.
You didn't go?
No, there was somewhere else I had to go instead. I was so worried, I had to go. I didn't know what to do with myself. I was so nervous.
So Pearls never went to Miss Donim's room, because she was too worried about something or someone else. Pearls? On the night of the murder, you went to this place, didn't you?
Sorry, my phone vibrated.
I was like, I guess that wasn't the answer. Show him who.
You gotta go to the inner temple.
Okay. You went here, didn't you, Pearls? Looks like she's still not going to open up to me. This is where you went because you were so worried, right? Then the next question is, who or what were you so worried about? Now, I'm gonna take a guess, and you can tell me if I'm right or wrong, okay?
You mean you know?
Well, if I'm right, will you tell me the whole truth?
Okay.
You went to this place for one very simple reason, and that is this.
Because of Maya. She was worried about her cousin.
Oh. It's obvious what you were so worried about, Pearls. It was Maya, wasn't it? You knew the training Maya was undertaking was dangerous. After all, it was a special course.
Oh yeah, the special course.
Where you sit on a block of ice until your butt gets numb and you... Ow! Ow! Do you know how bad it must hurt?
No, I don't know how bad it must hurt.
I'm not saying you go out and sit in a block of ice. I'm saying... You know, never mind. Jeez. Act like it's common knowledge. Oh, yeah, it's Friday evening. I'm going to go to my shack and sit on a block of ice I have stored. Sister Bikini scared you what she said, didn't she? And because it was you who introduced Hazakura Temple to Maya in the first place, you felt responsible, didn't you?
Thinking about what could happen to Mystic Maya made me more and more worried. I couldn't sit still at all. That's why I decided to go find out how she was doing at the Inner Temple.
Aww.
Then we're clear now that you went to the Inner Temple that night, Pearls. What's not clear is what happened after that. About what time was it when you headed over to the Inner Temple?
It was probably around 9:30 when I left the main hall. I heard the real training was supposed to start at 10. I wanted to get there before it started. There was so much snow and I didn't get there until after 10 o'clock.
Until after 10? How'd you know what time it was?
Because I heard the bell ringing for lights out.
She heard a lights out bell? The Hasakura Temple bell's pretty small though, isn't it? You must have really good hearing.
I was really trying to pick up the sound of that bell, that's all. I didn't want to miss it. That would be terrible.
She was trying to hear the bell? Well, tell me, Pearls, why were you so worried about hearing that bell?
Huh?
I think I know why. The reason you were so worried about that bell is because of this.
Oh wait, no, evidence. Okay, so remember that burnt letter we got?
Mm-hmm, that Gumshoe gave us?
Yes, as soon as you hear the lights out bell, you must... So, we gotta present this.
You were given some instructions to follow for that night, weren't you? I presume you recognize these pieces of paper?
Where did you...
In the incinerator at the inner temple. Pearls, you were following the instructions in this letter that night, weren't you? That's why you couldn't afford to miss the sound of the lights out bell.
I speechless, Mr. Nick, you're amazing.
Flattery will get you nowhere.
I know, but these instructions that were found in the incinerator, I believe they were written for you, Pearls.
For me? No!
As you can see, a large portion has been burnt, but the last section is still fairly legible. As soon as you hear the lights out bell, you must... Who was it, Pearls? Whose spirit were you supposed to be channeling? Taking into account the author of the note and their purpose for writing it, whose spirit would Pearls have been trying to channel? Don't overthink it, Phoenix. It's pretty obvious who Pearls is supposed to channel. The person you were trying to channel that night, Pearls, was...
None other than Dahlia Hawthorne.
Woohoo! It was Dahlia Hawthorne, wasn't it? That was the name that was in the letter. It's just as I suspected. It wasn't Iris whose sister Bikini met at the inner temple that night. It was Dahlia Hawthorne. Do you know anything about her, Pearls? Do you know what kind of a woman Dahlia Hawthorne was?
No.
Well, we use a big adult word called a bit. I mean, never mind.
Oh, God. I'd never heard of anyone by that name before reading those instructions.
I thought so. Pearls doesn't have a clue.
She's your half-sister!
Huh? She doesn't know that Dahlia is her sister. About the instructions in the letter I found, Pearls, who wrote them? Whoever was asked you to channel the spirit of someone you've never heard of, you must have quite a lot of respect for them. After all, you followed their instructions without question. So here's my next question. Who wrote the set of instructions for you to follow?
None other than Morgan Crazy Faye. Her mama.
Her mama? Wait, that's odd. They don't show her age.
They don't?
No.
For real?
You see that?
Yeah, that's weird.
Did they show her age in Justice for All? Because now I can't remember. Huh. Okay, then.
Oh, okay.
Pearls, I have to wonder about something. You didn't have any idea what these instructions meant, did you? But what the hell is that noise? Never mind. But you followed them to the letter regardless. Why? Was it because of your own mother? Because it was your own mother who asked you. That's why.
How did you...
I figured it out. The person who wrote you this letter was your own mother, Morgan Faye. Alright, Pearls, it's time you start telling me the truth.
Mr. Nick, I
Why is she holding back from me? I don't like this.
Don't underestimate me just because I'm a child.
Huh?
If you're trying to say I follow these instructions, then I'd like to see some proof.
What?
Because I don't think you have any.
No. Oh, she'd say anything other than rather than admit to carrying out these instructions. I guess I'll have to produce some more evidence then. One more thing should do it. Alright, Pearls. We both know someone carried out these instructions on a night of murder. But you're right. There's no evidence that proves it was you.
I knew it!
However, I do know that whoever did it was a child.
Huh? How do you know that?
It couldn't have been an adult. No adult would have made a simple mistake like that.
A simple mistake? What do you mean by that?
I'm sure you thought you were carefully following the instructions you've been given, but you misunderstood some of the words, and this is the evidence that proves it.
Oh, and this is like my favorite presenting evidence ever, because it's this hanging scroll is the piece of evidence because it's covered in gravy. If you read the note, it actually says gravely roast this letter.
Yeah, it says gravely roast the master of the fires of Hades and bring our vengeance to fruition.
So
yeah.
Poor Pearly. So this is what you want to present.
You know, gravy sounds good right about now.
Oh, gosh.
It was you who splattered gravy on this hanging scroll, wasn't it?
What? Why would I do something like that?
Do you remember what was written in that letter? Gravely roast the master in the fires of Hades and bring our vengeance to fruition. But you didn't know how to read the words gravely and roast, among others, right?
How did you know that?
Remember the conversation you had with Miss Donim on the night of the murder?
Oh yeah, she's like, what does this word say? Oh, would you like to practice reading? Yes.
How'd you read this? And it says, gravely! Get it!
Oh.
Sure, Miss Donim taught you how to read gravely and roast, but what she didn't teach you is what they meant.
Gravely sounded like gravy to me, and the only roast I could think of was the food.
And that's why you did it. That's why you covered a picture of the master in gravy from that night's post roast.
To be honest, I did think it was a bit strange. I guess I really did get the wrong idea.
Just a tiny bit.
I really am useless. I didn't even manage to burn the litter properly as my mother had asked me. Such a simple thing, and I couldn't even do it right.
Oh, Pearl.
Oh, Pearl. It's okay, she used you. It's okay. Yeah.
Your mother's just a big Bia. I mean, I know you don't. I can't really tell you that, but still.
Oh gosh. Okay, let's talk about the night of the crime then. Yeah.
Yeah.
After dinner that night, I did go to the inner temple, but with a pot full of the leftover gravy.
The gravy?
I saw the picture on the hanging scroll near the sacred cavern. It was I was sure it was the master of curing, like I said in the letter.
I see. And then?
Well, it was already way past 10 when I got there because of all the snow. So I went to the inner temple guest area.
The guest area?
Yes, I thought I could wait there until training was over.
Why didn't you just go to the training hall?
Because Isaac Maya's main training had already started, and I couldn't interrupt it. So I just stayed where I was and prayed for her to get through it. But then,
Pearls, did you fall asleep?
I'm sorry! I didn't mean to, I just couldn't help it!
Hey, don't worry about it, Pearl! Who cares if you fell asleep? I fell asleep
I forgot he was here.
Right, like this entire time just waiting on the side. It's like, thank you, Larry. And I fell asleep waiting for Iris too. It happens. Anyway, then you found yourself trapped in the inner temple.
Yes. When I woke up, it was morning. I tried not to cry, but the escape bridge wasn't there anymore, and there was no one in the training hall. I thought everyone had left me because I overslept. I threw the letter into the incinerator, then I heated up the leftover gravy and
let off some steam by chucking the gravy on the scroll while you cried.
Aww.
It must have been pretty scary for you, Pearl. I know what it's like. Nick used to leave me behind when I fell asleep at school, too. Don't equate something so trivial with her experience, Larry.
Okay, what do you mean by lost powers, then?
It was written right in my mother's letter. It said, as soon as you hear the lights out bell, you must channel her spirit. I was on my way over to the inner temple when I heard the bell ring.
So you channeled Dahlia Hawthorne's spirit?
No, I tried, but I couldn't do it.
You couldn't do it?
I've never failed at channeling someone. This is the first time it's happened. I tried and I tried and I tried. Yesterday, this morning, the whole time. But I just couldn't do it.
Don't let it get you down, Pearl. It'll all work out. If you want, I'll come flying through the sky for you. Whoosh! Just like that. What? Never mind. So she never managed to channel her spirit. Is that why you think your spiritual powers are gone?
Yes, I don't know what to do.
Well, isn't there any other explanation for you for why you couldn't channel a spirit?
I suppose there's one other possibility. It's not very likely, though.
Could you please tell me what it is anyway?
It could happen if someone else was already channeling the same spirit.
Someone else? What do you mean?
Well, there's only one of each spirit, right?
Yep, it's like the Asian girl, Nick. You can't see a hot chick if she's already taken.
I'm not
getting into that one at all. Then that would mean Ananias' murder. Someone else channeled her spirit before Pearl's could. Someone else channeled the spirit of Dahlia Hawthorne.
I'm a failure. I couldn't even grant my mother's final wish.
Her final wish?
Yes, this letter. This is my last wish, she said. So make sure you follow the instructions carefully.
This letter. I definitely need to find out more about it.
Let's ask her. Oh, yeah?
Oh, boy.
Sorry, guys. But what I understand is the fact that why didn't her mother just say plain and simple? Why she gotta add all this extra adjectives in there?
You know what? I was about to ask that myself. It's like, you're writing it for your own daughter who you know, or at least should know, does not know how to read very well.
Yeah.
So that's why, there could be a lot of possibilities for it. It could be just for the sake of the plot. Or what I would like to believe, because I think this kind of fits Morgan's personality, is she didn't give a crap, and she didn't know that she couldn't read.
Yeah.
So, who knows?
My mother has gone to a place called a penitentiary.
Yeah, I know, Pearls.
I visit her every month. And last month she told me...
Oh, yeah. Ugh.
The time we've been waiting for has come, Pearl. There's something I need you to do for me. I hid a letter for you at our home before they brought me here. I want you to read it and do exactly what it says. It's for the good of the Fae Clan, my angel. You'll be doing a great thing. Now listen carefully, and I'll tell you where the letter's hidden.
So, we're not going to mention how they lit like an 8 or 9 year old little girl into a penitentiary to a visitor center?
Yeah.
My mother's always nice to me. I love her so much!
Yeah! Moms do anything for their kids, right?
She said it was for the good of the Fae Clan, so I knew I had to help her. I mean, Mystic Mine is part of the Fae Clan, so it had to be good for her, too. That's right, isn't it, Mr. Nick?
I guess so, yeah.
There is a picture of her... There is a picture with her letter, too.
A picture?
Of Miss Dahlia Hawthorne. Usually a picture is enough to channel someone's spirit, but this time...
Pretty weird, huh? Like Larry knows anything about this stuff.
There's something else that was strange about my mother's letter. The seal on it was broken, as if somebody had already opened it once before.
That sure is pretty strange. Someone had opened it already?
Ah!
Huh. Thanks, Pearls. You really helped me out.
You're very welcome!
I don't know why I said it like that.
I'll let it go. I wasn't gonna say anything.
Oh, God.
My mother is watching over us, so I'm sure Miss Maya will be alright.
Look at that innocent smile on her face. What am I supposed to say to her? Oh. Ha! Finally figured it out, have you, Trite? You finally realize how terrible of a crime being painfully oblivious is. No! The entrance to the sacred cavern looks like a freaking puzzle workshop. I guess he's talking about Iris and a lockbreaking effort. But it's all a waste of time. Why do you say that? Because Maya Faye isn't coming back. What? You don't know what you're talking about! How can you say something like that? It was your job to protect her, Trite. Just like it was your job to protect Mia Faye. Two sisters caught up in the worst circumstances. I realize that, but... And you were the only one who was by their sides. You were the only one who could have saved them. But I didn't know anything about what was going on! What did I just say, Trite? Crime in itself. Ugh. Tomorrow. We'll settle everything in court tomorrow. Once and for all. What is this theme they're playing?
I don't know, but I don't remember it.
Wow, okay, yeah, I don't think I've ever... I really like this! Why come in? Okay, never mind. Let's keep going.
Mr. Nick! Is what that man just said true?
It'll be alright, Pearls. I'm sure Maya's alive. You'll see for yourself tomorrow.
Yeah, that's right! I knew I could trust you, Mr. Nick.
Oh, boy.
Godot, you douchebag. Oh, my dear Pearl.
You've done so well, my child. My Pearl. It's better that you don't know. I knew this day would come for you. The blood of the main family is no more. Now you are to take the place at the head of the Fae clan. My last great wish. It seems I was just in time.
God. Stupid lady.
I know that was just only one part of just breaking her cycle, but I knew it was gonna take a while.
Mm-hmm.
So, we will start the trial in the next episode, ladies and gentlemen.
And it will be a roller coaster ride, let me tell you.
Of emotion, so prepare your bodies.
Oh, well, I thought you were gonna say something else.
I'm not going to say the other one.
But?
Excuse me.
Well, there, that's... Okay.
Okay, guys, thank you so very much for watching, and if no one's told you that they love you today, I do.
And I hope you all have a great day.
Yeah. Bye.